I received a phone call the other day from a person, and this is how they started off the conversation. They say, "Brother Bassett, I enjoy your morning devotions, especially the one that I received the other day. But I'm calling you to tell you some things of how I am feeling right now." And I said to her, yes, it was a dear sister, and I think she had lost a loved one. She had lost her mom, and then recently she lost her son. And she felt like the whole world is weighing down upon her. And she said, "Brother Bassett, I feel like I just cannot make it anymore." The title of this morning devotion is, "When You Feel Like You Can't Take It Anymore, What Do I Do? Who Do I Turn To?" I want you to know that there is a name, and that name is hope. Say that with me. Hope. H-O-P-E. Hallelujah. And I want you to know today, and this is what I told that their sister. I told her, I said, "Don't you give up hope in spite of what you are going through. We are all going to go through something, because that is a part of this life. But sometimes what we are going through seems more heavier than it usually be. And sometimes we want to throw in the towel. But in spite of it, we have to trust and depend on God and believe that we have hope in our God." And I want you to know, child of God, trumpeters and prayer partners, hope has a name, and that name is Jesus. Jesus Christ, that is the name of hope. When you feel like you can't take it anymore, oh child of God, you trust in the name that is above every name, and that name is Jesus. There is power in that name. That name is not weak. That name is strong. That name is above every name that is in the earth, above the earth, and beneath the earth. There is no other name like it, and there will never, ever be another name like it. Don't trust in your doctors or your lawyers or your government or anyone else. Hallelujah. For your situation of what you are going through, but you trust in God. Trust and obey, for there is no other way. Hallelujah. I'm not saying disrespect the government or disrespect your pastor or whomever there is. They are there, amen, for a particular reason and for a particular service. But the ultimate trust that you have to depend on is Jesus Christ, and He will see you through no matter what you are going through. Trust in the Lord, and He will see you through your circumstances. And I began to encourage that sister, and I gave her a word found in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 15 and verse 7. And this is where this morning devotion is going to be kicked off from. And this is what it says. It says, be ye strong therefore, and let not your, hallelujah, let not your hands be weak. Amen. Hallelujah. For your works shall be rewarded. Be ye strong therefore, and let not your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. Whatever you are going through, child of God, always, and I know you've heard this, you are not going through it for yourself. You are going to come through this if you only learn how to wait on God. Remember, the scripture says in several parts of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, I love what it says. It says, and it came to pass. It didn't come to stay. It came to pass. All of what you are going through right now, it is not going to stay. Aren't you glad that it's not going to stay? It may feel like it's going to stay. It may feel like it's hanging around, but don't you dwell on it. Don't you hang on it. Don't you worry about it. You trust in Jesus. Hope, hallelujah, will never let you down. That hope is your anchor, like that powerful song, the anchor holds. Trust in God, hallelujah, and he will see you through. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 18 and verse 16, he sent from above. Hallelujah. He took me and drew me out of many waters. Sometimes that's how you feel. You feel like you're going through many waters and you can't breathe. Hallelujah. What I want you to know, child of God, before you throw in the towel, hallelujah, take a moment, stop, breathe, pause, and realize that hope is standing right there with you, and that hope is Jesus. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will always be with you until the ends of the world. You may have lost your mother. God is with you. You may have lost your father. God is with you. You may have lost a son or a daughter. God is with you. He knows exactly what you are going through, and he said, I will not allow you to bear more than you can stand. God knows exactly how much you can bear. Hallelujah. When you feel like you cannot bear it anymore, that's why he is there. He is there for you, hallelujah, to help you through whatever you're going through. He tells us in the book of Psalms, chapter 46 and verse, hallelujah, 5, God is in the midst of her. Amen. He shall not be moved. God is with you. He is with you. He will never be moved. Your problems, hallelujah, will not discourage God from helping you. Your problems may discourage other people, hallelujah, from helping you, because they don't want nothing to do with your problems, because they only want to be there when you are enjoying the good times. But when you're going through the bad times, nobody wants to be there for you. Hallelujah. Sad to say, sometimes your best friend that you are calling on may not even want to answer the phone because of caller ID, and they say, oh, it's him, oh, it's her, I don't want to talk to them right now. Hallelujah. But I'm telling you, when you pick up the phone and you call on Jesus, he will never, hallelujah, hang up on you. He'll never say, oh, it's her, oh, it's him. He'll say, I need to answer my child, because she or he are going through something. Trust me, child of God, Jesus loves you more than you can remember. Hallelujah. He tells us, hallelujah, in the book of Jeremiah, Amen. Chapter 29 and verse 11. He says, "For I know the thoughts," hallelujah, "that I think towards you." Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. God is always thinking of you. God is always thinking about you. You say, "He's thinking about me?" Yes, God's got you on his mind. Hallelujah. And when he has you on his mind, sometimes he's saying, "Why isn't my child calling on me? Why isn't my baby girl or my baby boy isn't calling on me? I see what they're going through," but God will not invade your life, amen, hallelujah, to push you to call on him. That's why we need to develop a relationship with God so we can feel him every time we walk. And when we're going through ups and downs and trials and tribulation, we know that he would always be there. But when we don't have that time with God, hallelujah, child of God, it will feel like eternity because we just don't have that intimacy with our God. Trust God. Hope is on your side. Hope is not against you. When you feel like you're going through situations and you cannot make it, you need to lift up your hands and say, "Praise the Lord, because God is with you all the time."
When you're up against the struggle that shatters all your dreams, and your hopes have been cruelly crushed by Satan's manifested schemes, and you feel the urge within you to submit to earthly fear, don't let the faith you're standing in seem to disappear. To make us think that we are paupers, when he knows himself that we're children of the King. So lift up the mighty shield of faith, for the battle must be won. We know that Jesus,
hallelujah,
Christ is risen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
So
praise. Come on, child of God. Praise him. It's not over. You're not at the end. You're not at the end. Hallelujah. And you're not going to give up. I have confidence in you, and God has confidence in you. You are not going to give up. You are not going to fail. You are not going to throw in the towel. You are an overcomer because Jesus lives in you. Lift your hands up and praise the Lord right now. Come on. You're not praising him by yourself. Oh, you've got a host of angels standing with you and holding up your hands and saying, "My child, you are going to make it." Praise him. Come on, give him all the praise. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Praise him. 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 Come on. It's a big finish. Come on, everybody. Take a big breath. Take a deep breath. And lift up your hands and say, "Praise the Lord." Up your hands right where you are and say, I don't have any trouble. All I have is faith in God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Be encouraged, child of God. Be encouraged, and everything is going to be all right. Amen. Hallelujah. It's going to be all right. Hey, listen up. We are going to be in Freeport, Grand Bahama. Amen. Coming up. Praise the Lord. This coming October. Hallelujah. And we want you to be there with us. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's going to be a great time, great joy in the city at New Canaan Zion Baptist Church, October the 22nd through the 25th. All service starts nightly. Amen. Hallelujah. Be blessed. Be encouraged. For more information, contact me at 952-240-0047. Be blessed today in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord.